tested here was a top-of-the-line grand touring hatchback model fitted with the only engine available with it trim, a 2.5-liter naturally aspirated inline 4, and a 6-speed manual transmission. A 6-speed automatic is a $1,050 option. A sedan can be had for $750 less, but we'd gladly pay the premium for the extra storage space and the easy access liftgate. We think that the hatch simply looks better, too. Our test car rang in at $28,030, handsomely equipped with the Grand Touring's standard leather-trimmed interior, power seats, and 7.0-inch touchscreen infotainment display with redundant rotary controller. It also carried the $1,600 premium equipment package, LED lighting, adaptive headlights, navigation, and a heated steering wheel, and the $1,100 active safety package, lane departure warning, lane keeping assist, adaptive cruise control, and Mazda's smart braking system, a form of automated braking assist. Most automakers won't let American buyers have these optional safety features with a manual transmission, preferring that the car be able to select gears on its own if, say, traffic conditions require the adaptive cruise control to slow it down from freeway speeds to a crawl. Mazda's system, which operates between 18 and 99 miles per hour, alerts the driver via a dashboard warning and chime to assume control and shift down to avoid stalling the engine in such circumstances. The car didn't distinguish itself in braking, either, needing a considerable 185 feet to stop from 70 miles per hour, or 20 feet more than the long-term test car needed when it was similarly new. A Ford Focus SE EcoBoost we tested earlier this year needed only 173 feet, while a Volkswagen Golf TSI took just 168. Not many cars in the segment outperform the Mazda 3's 0.84 grams of grip on the skid pad, but many match it, so it can't rightly be called the leader of the pack. The 3 returned 34 miles per gallon on our 75-mile-per-hour, 200-mile highway fuel economy test, besting the EPA's 33-mile-per-gallon highway rating. With its smaller displacement turbocharged engine, the 2016 VW Golf achieved 40 miles per gallon in the same test. The Mazda 3's best qualities can't be accounted for in braking distances or acceleration times. Instead, it's the subjective elements that make the Mazda great: the obedience of the steering, the confidence-inspiring gearbox, the inner chassis, the upscale interior. All the controls feel balanced, delivering proportionate responses to equivalent efforts. This Mazda is the kind of car that brings out the best in the driver, even if it's just on the daily commute. It's so easy to drive well that it discourages lazy habits in favor of trying to perfect every shift and carve every corner.